डियर स्टूडेंट, आज के लेक्चर में हम सिंपल इंटरेस्ट एंड कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट पढ़ने वाले हैं। ओके, सो देयर आर स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्मूलेस ऑफ सिंपल इंटरेस्ट एंड कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट, दैट क्लियर, एंड वी विल यूज दोज फॉर्मूलेस फॉर द रियल लाइफ एग्जांपल्स, दैट क्लियर। सो व्हाट इज सिंपल इंटरेस्ट, what is compound interest, what are their formulas, how they can be used, is that clear? So before going to start the lecture, please subscribe our channel if you are not subscribed yet, so that you will get the updates automatically when we upload a new lecture. Okay, so can we start compound interest? Now under that, what is a simple interest? Simple interest is a method to calculate the interest on the original principal amount with the same rate of interest. Is that clear? So here, look at here. Rate of interest is same. Okay, and it is calculated on the original principal amount, is that clear? And the formula for it is SI is equal to P into R into T divided by 100. Okay, what is P? P is the principal. What is R? R is rate of interest per annum. What is T? Is a period, that is year. Okay, and what is SI? SI is a simple interest. Is that clear? So that is, now let us see the first example. A principal is rupees 5000. Is that clear? And rate of interest is 10%. Then find a simple interest for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. Okay, so this 1 year, what? T is equal to 1, T is equal to 2, T is equal to 3. Three different periods are given. And R is what? That is fixed, 10%. Per annum. Is that clear? So, and what is P? P is equal to, what is the principal amount? 5000 rupees. Okay, so let us see the first simple interest for 1 year. What is the formula here? SI is equal to P into R into T divided by 100. P itna hai? P is 5000. R 10. And 1 year. Okay, divided by 100. So 10 get cancelled, 10 get cancelled, 10 here, 10 here. So what is left? Rupees 500. Is that clear? Rupees 500. Now similarly, simple interest for 2 year. So what is here again? P. SI is equal to P is 5000. R 10%. T is now 2 divided by 100. Okay. Again, this 20, 20 get cancelled. So what is left? 5 into 10, 50. 5000. This is 5000. So this is what, 20 can, after cancelling 20, 50 into 10, 500 into 2 is what? Rupees 1000. So look at here. For 1 year, the simple interest was 5000. For second year, for 2 year, it is 1000. It is 500. It is 1000. Meaning double. Okay. Similarly, simple interest for 3 years. So that is SI is equal to P is 5000, R is 10, T is 3 divided by 100. Again, this 20 will get cancelled. So 50 into 10, 500 into 3, rupees 1500. So it is 3 times, it is double, and it is triple of this. So that is the relation of simple interest cumulative. Matlab 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, just double getting multiple. Okay. Without changing the principal amount. So that is what it is calculated on the original principal amount only. Now compound interest. Is that clear? Now compound interest. The interest on principal calculated on both, that is initial principal and the accumulated interest rate principal. Okay. So the principal accumulated by the interest rate from the previous period. That is principal plus interest for the next term. Is that clear? So the interest on principal amount calculated on both the initial principal and accumulated interest from previous period. That is principal plus interest. That is for what? For next period. Is that clear? So case 1. Now case 1 is what? Where interest is compounded yearly. When interest is a compound interest, we need to calculate when interest is compounded yearly. Okay. So let us see example. Example. So find the compound interest on rupees 1000 for 2 years at the rate of interest 4% per year. So what will happen here? We will calculate the simple interest for first year. Okay. And then for next year, principal plus simple interest, it will become P1, that is new principal. And then we calculate the simple interest on P1. And that will become, that is become a compound interest. Is that clear? Understand? So let us see solution. So principal for first year. What is the principal for first year? Rupees 1000. Is that clear? What is the rate of interest? 4% per year. Is that clear? Now interest for first year, what is the formula? SI P into R into T by 100. So P is 1000, R is 4, T is 1 first year and upon 100. So these 20 get cancelled. So it is what? Rupees 40. Is that clear? So this interest now for next year, P1 and a principal. So what will be this principal? Original principal plus first year interest. This is 40 rupees. Okay. So original principal is 1000 rupees plus interest 40, that is 1040. Is that clear? So we have principal P1 for next year. Kitna hai? Kitna? What is the principal P1 for next year? Original principal plus interest for first year, that is rupees 1040. Is that clear? Now interest for second year. Formula is same. That is what? P into N into R into R into T, okay, divided by 100. So it is equal to P is how much now? 1040, P1, not P, P1, okay, into R is 4%, T is what? Again, this is for second year only, so 1, okay, and divided by 100, okay, so what we have, it is equal to, this 10 get cancelled, is that clear? Now 104 into 4, so that is what? (clears throat) 416 divided by 10. Okay, and so it is equal to 41.6 rupees is interest. Is that clear? So 41.6, and therefore total amount at the end of thus the amount at the end of 2 years was. That is P1 plus interest for second year, and that is equal to what is P1? 1040, and what is the interest for second year? 41.60. So it is equal to 1081.60 rupees is the amount after 2 years. Is that clear? Now compound interest we need to calculate. And therefore, compound interest ka formula kya hoga? Compound interest ka formula hoga ki total amount minus original principal. Total amount is 1081.60. And minus original principal is 1000 rupees. So it is equal to 81.60 rupees is the compound interest. Is that clear? So that is the compound interest. Understand? Okay. So now case 2. Let us discuss case 2 is what? When the interest is computed half yearly. Compound interest, where interest is computed half yearly. Let us see example. Find the compound interest on rupees 8000 for 1.5 years at the rate of interest 10% per year. Is that the rate of interest is 10% per year, interest being payable half yearly. Okay, so what we'll get here, principal P is rupees 8000. What is the rate of interest? 10% yearly, and R by 2 is equal to 10/2, that is 5% half yearly. Okay. Is that clear? Now look here. Half yearly rate of interest R by 2 is equal to 5%. We already calculated. Okay. Now interest for first half year is equal to what? What is the formula? P into R by 2 into first half, that is 1. Okay. Divided by 100. So it is equal to P is 8000, R by 2 is 5, divided by 100 into 1. Okay, so that is 2020 get cancelled. So 80 into 5, that is equal to rupees 400. That is interest for first half. Now for second half, principal for second half P1. So is equal to what? P, an original principal, plus interest. Barabar hai? The P is 8000 plus interest is 400. So it is equal to 8400 rupees. Is that clear? P1. and therefore interest for second half is what again? P1 into R by 2 into 1 divided by 100. So it is equal to P1 is 8400, R by 2 is 5 into 1 divided by 100. So these two zero get cancelled. So 84 into 5 into 1 is 5, and this 5 into 84 is how much? It is 20 420. Okay, so that is 420 is the interest for second half. Okay, now this interest for second half will calculate, will add to the principal for second half, and that will become principal for third half. Okay, and therefore principal for third half P2 is equal to what? P1 plus interest. So P1 is 8400 plus interest on is 420, and so it is equal to 8820. Is that clear? 8820 rupees the principal amount for third half. Okay, and now interest for third half is formula what? P2 into R by 2 into 1 divided by 100. Now P2 is how much? P2 is 8820, R by 2 is 5 into 1 divided by 100. Is that clear? So 10 get cancelled. Now we multiply 8820 by 5. So 5 2s are 10, 5 8 is 40 plus 141, 5 8 is 40, that is 44, 4410 divided by 10, and that is equal to 441.0 rupees. Okay, and therefore what is the interest for this, what, third half? Okay, and therefore what is the total amount? Therefore total amount at the end of third half year is what? That is P2 plus interest. Okay, and P2 kitna hai? 8820 plus 441, and that is equal to how much? 9261 rupees, a total amount. And what is the compound interest now? From this total amount, we subtract the original principal amount, and therefore compound interest is equal to what? Total amount minus original principal. Total amount is 9261 minus original principal is 8000, and therefore it is equal to rupees 1261 is a compound interest. Is that clear? So this is case 2. So in case 1, the interest was calculated yearly. In case 2, interest is calculated half yearly. Now case 3, interest is calculated quarterly, means in a year 4 times. Okay, so compound interest, when interest is compounded quarterly. Let us see example. Find the compound interest on rupees 10,000. Rupees 10,000 for 1 year at the rate of 20%. 20% per year. Per year. Okay, this is per year. Compounded quarterly. Quarterly means what? And for is the here interest will be calculated first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, and fourth quarter, so that it will become 1 year. Is that clear? So let us see solution. So in this, principal is how much? 10,000. Okay, rate of interest R is 20%. Okay. And quarterly rate of interest R by 4 is 20 by 4, that is equal to 5%. Is that clear? That is 5%. Now we calculate interest for first quarter. Okay. So interest for first quarter is, what is the formula? Formula P into R by 4 into 1 divided by 100. Now P is 10,000, R by 4 is 5, to 1 divided by 100. So 2 zeros get cancelled. So 100 into 5, that is rupees 500, is the interest for first quarter. Is that clear? And therefore principal for second quarter P1 kitna hoga? P plus 500. That is equal to 10,000 plus 500. That is 10,500. Is that clear? This is P1. And therefore, interest for second quarter is P1 into R by 4 into 1 divided by 100. So P1 is 10,000 into R by 4 is 5 into 1 divided by 100. This is 10,500. Sorry, P1 kitna hai? 10,500. So now 2 0 get cancelled. So 105 into 5, that is 525 rupees, is the interest for second quarter. Okay, and therefore, what is the principal for second quarter? P2 is equal to P1 plus interest for second quarter is 525, and therefore it is 10,500 plus 525, that is what? 11,025. Is that clear? So that is the rupees. 11,025 is the P2, and therefore interest for third quarter is P2 into R by 4 into 1 divided by 100. So P2 is how much? 11,025 into R by 4, 5 into 1 divided by 100. Is that clear? So you calculate this. So if we calculate this, 5 is 5, 520 is 100. Then 5 2 is 10, 5 2 is 10, 5 5 is 25, and here is 5 4 is 20. So now we divide by 4. 4 5 is 20, 4 5 is 4.25 rupees. 5 5 1.25 rupees is the interest for third quarter. Now therefore principal for fourth quarter is P2 plus interest for third quarter, that is 551.25, and that is, what is P2? P2 is 11,025 plus 551.25, and so P3 is 11,576.25 rupees. This is P3. Okay, and therefore interest for fourth quarter is how much? That is the P3 into R by 4 into 1 divided by 100. That is 11,576.25. R by 4 is 5 into 1 divided by 100. Do the calculation. So if we do the calculation here, so it will comes out 578.57 78.81. Similar, 5 ones are 5 and 20, 5 20 is 100. And we divide by 20 here to this number, so you will get this. Is that clear? And therefore, what is the, this is what? Interest after 4th quarter. This was the interest after 3rd quarter. This was the interest after 2nd quarter. And this was the interest after 1st quarter. Is that clear? Now look at here. Thus, amount after 1 year is what? P3 plus, what is the interest? 578.81. That is 11576.25 plus 578.81, and that is equal to how much? 12,155.06 rupees. And if we subtract the original principal, that is 10,000 from here, so you will get CI. Therefore, compound interest is equal to what? 12,155.06 minus 10,000, and that is equal to rupees 2155.06 is the compound interest. Is that clear? That is compound interest. Now there are direct formulae for calculation of compound interest. Here what we did in this previous examples, we find out the interest successively. And first we calculated simple interest, then it is added to the principal, then it become new principal, then again simple interest on new principal, then again it is added to the new principal, then again simple interest on the next new principal. Is that clear? So likewise, successive calculation of interest here we made. But if we use these formulae, we can get direct the amount and compound interest. Okay, so what is the formula? First formula is A, that is amount, is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 into N. Okay, A is what? A is the amount. R is what? Rate of rest. P is what? Principal. Is that clear? And CI is what? Compound interest. Is that clear? Similarly, dusra formula. Suppose that there is a rate of interest for different terms, different rate of interest. Okay, and then the formula varies. When rate of interest changes time to time. In the first quarter, the rate of interest suppose R1. Second quarter, suppose rate of interest is R2. Third quarter, suppose rate of interest is R3. Or first year, rate of interest is R1. Second year, rate of interest is R2. Third year, rate of interest is R3, and so. Then, the formula will be A is equal to P into 1 plus R1 by 100. R1, this is the rate of interest for first year. R2, rate of interest for second year. R3, rate of interest for third year, and so on. Rn is rate of interest for nth year. Okay, then this amount is calculated. And similarly, CI formula is same. CI is equal to A minus P. CI is equal to A minus P. Is that clear? So, let us see example. Abhay lent rupees 8000 to his friends for 3 years. Abhay ne apne dost ko 3 saal ke liye kitne rupaye diye? 8000. At the rate of interest 5% per annum. Compound interest. Okay. What amount does Abhay get after 3 years? Okay. So look at here. What is given? Okay. So see. Principal is 8000. Rate of interest is 5% per annum, means per year. Okay. Then number of years, for how many years he has given? 3 years. Okay. So what is the formula now? The formula is A equal to P into P is given, R is given, N is given. So what is the formula? P kitna hai? 8000 into 1 plus R is how much? 500 raised to the power N is 3. Okay, so it is equal to 8000 1 plus 5 1 by 5 5 20 is 100. So 1 plus 1 by 20 raised to the power 3. Okay, so that is equal to 8000 into 21 by 20 raised to the power 3. Okay, so 8000 into 21 into 21 into 21 by 20 into 20 into 20. Is that clear? So this 20 into 20 into 20 is 8000. This get cancelled. And therefore 21 into 21 into 21 is how much? 92. That is equal to rupees 9261. Okay, because 21 into 21, this square is a 441 into 21. Okay, so we can do like this. So this is the amount, and therefore what is the compound interest? And therefore compound interest kitna hoga? That is the A minus P. A is 9261 minus P is how much? 8000. So what you will get? 1261 rupees is the earning to away. This much amount got to away. Okay. Now example number 6. Ram Singh buys a refrigerator for rupees 4000 on credit. Refrigerator for rupees 4000 on credit. The rate of interest for first year was 5% and that of second year for 15%. How much will it cost him if he pays the amount after 2 years? It is very simple. Okay, so in this example, what is given? Principal. Principal amount is 4000. Okay, now rate of interest for first year R1 kitna hai? 5%. Okay, rate of interest for second year R2 is 15%. Okay, so we have to use that second formula, right? P into 1 plus R1 by 100 raised into 1 plus R2 by 100. Is that clear? That is equal to, yeah, this formula we have to use. Is that clear? So the amount for 2 years is this. So what we have? It is equal to P is 4000. 1 plus R1 is 5 by 100. 1 plus R2 is 15 by 100. That's clear? And that is equal to 4000. 1 plus 1 by 20. 1 plus how much? 3 by 20. Is that clear? And therefore 4000 into 21 by 20 into 23 by 20. Okay, so look at here, it is equal to 4000 into 21 into 23. 21 3 is 63. 21 to the 42 plus 6 48, right, divided by 400. So look at here, this 2 0 get cancelled and this 4 1 is 4, 4 1 is 4, to 10, and therefore it is equal to 4830 rupees he has to pay. How much he paid? rate 30 amount cost for 2 years. Is that clear? So that is the, so in this way, in this today's lecture, we learn how to calculate simple interest, compound interest. If you like the lecture, please subscribe the channel and share it and like it. Thank you. Thank you very much.